Heard of Daniel Dillips? Daniel Dillips, aka the most annoying Rashid to play against in the world. He is so good at frustrating you. So good at it. And he played against Infiltration earlier and lost the first game in record time. Infiltration, the absolute Rashid slayer, by the way. This guy has run the Rashid gauntlet. He always picks Jury for that matchup. He always batters all the Rashids, all the Japanese ones.
Yeah, you saw him.
Oil King included from Taiwan as well. He just batters all of them. But Daniel Dillips brought it to 1-1, Logan. And we were all like, what is going on here?
See?
That's how effective the guy's style is.
Listen, I prognosticated.
No, this is, but even, listen, even if, thank you, thank you. I was going to say, even if you main Rashid, it is not a good idea to pick Rashid against Gachikun. Gachikun plays against the territory that is more flooded.
He just won't be ready.
He plays a mirror match more than anyone else in the world.
He won't be ready for a 2-pack style.
The dupes, yeah. The dupes. I mean, this guy put Laura on the map quite early, didn't he?
Definitely, man. Especially when he went to the States. Was it DreamHack?
Yeah.
He went to? Yeah, they definitely weren't ready for Laura.
It's DreamHack Austin or something, or Texas. I can't remember. Like that. He went in.
Then one there. But here we go, winners. In pool, I'm going to say pool C. Check at home, smashed at GG, of course. Well, we are on the front page of that. Gachikun. With his customary Sinbad costume. Going up against Spring Break Laura with the Cane Rose.
Oh, needs to finish your plate there. Had the counter hit jab, didn't convert. Knocked down and momentum so important for Laura. Especially if they've taken away momentum for her. That's where she's changed, really. Still fundamentally the same character. Just late on that whiff punch.
Oh, nice. That was a nice answer to get underneath that neutral jump fizz.
It probably was, wasn't it? It committed. Oh, count. He's got us two count hits he's had now, not converted. Two-pack looking a bit rusty here. Wow. Full screen overhead.
Gachikun using V-trigger 1 here as well. That's interesting. Hmm.
Wow, anti-air. Freaking crouching fierce.
Is that people just take that? Those two taps and then that's it. Walk back.
Ooh. No. Says Gachikun.
That definitely wasn't a reaction. He just threw it out there.
He just kept it. He knew he was going to try something. Makes sense to put that out there.
Well, you could just keep doing it. Through the
they put a nice little gap there, didn't he? Just to make him think maybe he would have. Wow.
Oh, wow. Press his buttons up.
I like the idea from 2-pack, but Gachikun was ready. Trying to EX something there. Good jump. But be careful now. Can't guess wrong again. That's it. It's done.
He does not leave the damage on the table when he gets a counter hit. Gachikun's been doing that since season one with this character. You talk about people who put characters on the map. Gachikun definitely put this character. You remember that classic set with him against Daigo? It was like the first time I'd ever seen high-level Rashid. All the players that picked up Rashid complaining about his damage output and what have you, and you saw Gachikun against Daigo's Ryu. That's how long ago it was.
Dealing serious damage as well.
Crazy sets. Gachikun has been innovating this character for a very, very long time, and that is why he is currently 13th.
Were you slightly surprised as well to see Rashid like get ditched by guys like Monkey so quickly? I mean, the character's been nerfed, but still very effective.
I think he's still definitely effective. He's still got a lot of stuff that he had before. There's just holes, man. There's definitely more holes now than he used to be. He used to be watertight. He'd smother.
He'd really smother
you in the corner really badly.
Sounds like he's just got to think a little bit more, really, which just surprises me.
Well, looks like Will2Pac's thinking a little bit at the moment, seeing what he can do.
He had the timing down to counter hit the buttons.
Yeah, he just needs to be ready to catalyze, you're right.
Nice jump forward.
So he's looking for that whirlwind cancel at least.
Some familiarity with the Rashid character.
For a neutral jump for that mixer. Neutral.
Nice
interruption. That's really good spacing from Gachikun.
Yeah, perfect button choice as well. Just underneath that fireball to catch her legs.
Yeah, just clip the star. And of course the fireball completely disappears if you catch the star.
Oh, that's perfectly timed. Counter hit confirms here. As Gachikun goes to work. Empty jump low
was so cheeky.
Gachikun moves into match point here. 2-pack hasn't been able to get anything going.
Gachikun, one of those guys that you just associate that neutral jump heavy punch with. That's why that empty jump low is so cheeky.
He's just so committed to blocking it, right?
Yeah.
Here it comes again.
Yeah. Oh, no. Different button.
Oh, button at the wrong time and space.
Just stun there. Oh, that time he jump throws.
One more hit will stun.
The corner pressure too much.
She doesn't have that kind of damage output in this scenario.
Saves all the bar as well, which I like.
Oh, finally he's done stun throw. Wow.
2-pack not happy with himself there.
Rashid, yeah, the shake of the head in disappointment that he did really well.
Yeah, the first game was too many dropped opportunities, but that was just a steamroll in the second game. Didn't really have any opportunities to take, and it was all Gachikun. The pressure was too much.